Hello students, welcome to the third session of mathematics. In the previous two sessions, we have discussed four inverse trigonometric function, inverse of sine, cos, tan and cot. In this session, we are going to discuss more inverse functions, that is sec inverse and cosec inverse. So we'll first start with the sec function and we will define its inverse and see that what should be its domain and range. So first thing we need to check here, that the sec x function is 1 1 or not here. Now just to check the function is 1 1 or not, we take this horizontal line test. It means that we draw a line which is parallel to x axis and see if the graph intersects with this line at more than one point or not. And here we can clearly see that the graph it intersecting with the line at more than one point, and it means that we have at so many values of x we have the same value of fx. That means this function is many to one. Many values of x has the same value of y. So definitely this function is not 1 1. And the range of sec x function is r minus interval minus 1 to 1. That means the values is greater than or equal to 1 or the values less than or equals to minus 1. So this function is definitely onto. So we are not going to change anything in this. We will just alter its domain such that this function becomes 1 1. Before that, we'll just see that this is a sec x function and this is the domain of the sec x function. Wherever this cos x is not defined, because sec is reciprocal of cos x, so we'll just exclude all those values. So here we have excluded all odd multiples of pi by 2. So while defining the inverse of sec, we will also take care of this thing. Now here we have just restricted this graph for some interval so that it becomes 1 1, because this function is already onto in which domain it is defined. So we will just see that the function is 1 1 in the given interval. So we will 0 to pi minus pi odd multiples of pi by 2. This part we have taken and other part we have removed from the graph. Now here you can see that only this part of the graph we are taking and the other part we have not taken in consideration. So here for this part, if we take the horizontal line test, we can clearly see that this line is intersecting with the graph at only one point. That means for fx, we have only one value of x. That means for each value of x, there is one fx. For no two value of x, there is one fx. So this function becomes clearly 1 1. And this was already onto because the range of the function was equal to the codomain. So by altering its the domain of sec x, we have made this function 1 1 and onto. So now we can define the inverse of sec. This sec function is 1 1 and onto in this interval. Interval is 0 to pi minus pi by 2, because odd multiples of pi by 2, the sec x is not defined. So we have just taken this interval and this is the domain of the graph. Now in this interval, the sec x function becomes invertible. Now we denote this inverse by sec inverse, and we have already discussed that the sec inverse does not mean the reciprocal of sec. Sec inverse means the inverse function of sec function. Now see here that we can make this function 1 1 and onto not only the given interval which we have discussed right now. We can make this function 1 1 and onto in different intervals also, like the previous discussed function tan inverse and cot inverse. We can also make this function 1 1 and onto in this interval minus 2 pi to minus pi, in which we exclude this 3. This is minus 3 pi by 2 we have to exclude. Here pi to 2 pi we have to exclude this 3 pi by 2, because at all multiples of pi by 2 this sec x function will not be defined. There's just an error in this slide. This should be minus 3 pi by 2. Okay. So we can define the sec inverse in different intervals. But again, as discussed, that we have to decide one branch, and this is called principal value branch. At other points also, the sec inverse function will be defined. Like suppose if we define our sec inverse in this interval, it is defined as a function. If we define our sec inverse in the other interval, this means this one, then also the sec inverse function is defined. But by default, if nothing is stated, then we consider this interval as the principal value branch, and our answer should lie between the values which are given in the principal value branch. So second verse x here shall always mean this function. That means this is second verse. It is minus infinity to minus 1 to 1. We have again excluded, as we said, the range of the second verse will now become the domain of sec, and the principal value branch we have included. So these are the two properties that will be discussed during the property section. Now graph of sec x, as we have seen that this is the graph of sec x, this is the green part of the graph we can see. And when we have to draw inverse of sec or any inverse function, that we discussed also, that we have to draw a line, this is called y equal to x, and we will draw a mirror image of the given function. So here we can clearly see that this is the y equals to x line, and the mirror image of this sec x is clearly this red part, okay, and this mirror image of this green part is this one. So now this method we can follow for any function whose inverse is defined and we have to draw the inverse function. Now let's start with one example. We have to find the principal value of sec inverse minus 2. Same method we will follow. Sec inverse minus 2 is equal to y. Sec y is equal to minus 2. Now we have to find a value of y so that sec y is equal to minus 2. Now we have the range is 0 to pi, but we do not include pi by 2 in this. So we know that in this interval 0 to pi, we are having this these two coordinates 0 to pi by 2 and pi by 2 to pi. And pi by 2 to pi, the sec inverse will be negative. So definitely the value will lie between pi by 2 to pi. Now here this value is 2 pi by 3. We have already learned the method of finding these values in 11th class. So this is sec 2 pi by 3 is minus 2. So we can say that the value of y here is sec, it's 2 pi by 3. Okay. So we have just calculated the value in the principal value branch. If stated the other branches, we can also find the value in the other branches. The similar method we will follow to find the inverse of cosec function or cosecant function. Here, the same way, first we'll discuss the cosec function. This is f of x is equals to cos x. We know that the cosec function is the reciprocal of sine x function, and sine x is 0 at all integral multiples of pi. So definitely we'll exclude it from the cosec domain. Here we have excluded x is equals to n pi from the domain of cosecs, and the range and or the codomain of sec and cosec function both are same. It's r minus minus 1 to 1 open interval. Now let's first check whether this cosec function is 1 1 or onto or not. Now clearly we can see that the codomain and range of this function is same. So this function is onto, but this function is not 1 1. And the same horizontal line test we are going to do. So when we draw a line which is parallel to x-axis, we can see that this line is intersecting this graph at more than one point. So clearly we can see that for so many values of x, we are going to get the same values of x, fx. That means many to one mapping. So we have to include only one part of the graph where this function becomes 1, 1. And we have chosen this interval as minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That means only this part of the graph we are including and other part we are excluding. So we just draw this part of the graph here, and we can see that now this horizontal line test also says that this function is 1, 1. And this function was already onto. So now in this interval, the function becomes 1, 1 and onto. So now we can define the inverse of cosec. Now here cosec function is 1, 1 and onto in the given interval. We can just invert this function. That means if we define the cosec inverse x, this becomes its domain and this becomes its range. Cosec becomes interval, invertible, sorry. So we denote this cosec by again cosec inverse. I repeat again that this cosec inverse does not mean 1 upon cosec. This means inverse of cosec function. Now let's just find out the range and domain of cosec inverse. Here cosec domain will become the range of the cosec inverse, and the cosec function's range becomes the domain of cosec inverse function. Now can we not restrict this function in any other interval? Definitely we can do, as we have done for the other intervals, and you can just see that we can also define this function in the given interval, or in this interval, or in this interval, or in this interval also. That means we can just see that different parts of the graph we can include here, either this or this or this part. In all these parts the graph will be, or the function will be 1 1 and 1 2. But this mentioned value here, it is principal value branch. Like if it is not mentioned, then we always consider this interval as the principal value branch. That means our answer should always lie between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and we exclude 0 from that interval. Now the graph of cosec inverse will draw in the same way. This green part shows the graph of the cosec function. We draw a y equals to x line, then we will draw the mirror image of cosec function by considering this y equals to x as a line, and the mirror image what we get is basically the inverse of the cosec function. Let's do one example of finding the value of cosec inverse minus 2 by root 3. Now the cosec inverse minus 2 by root 3 is equals to y. We just take inverse on both the sides, so we know that cosec y is equals to minus 2 by root 3. Now the interval in which y value can lie is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, excluding 0. So here cosec is negative in the fourth quadrant, so definitely our value will lie between minus pi by 2 to 0 here, because 0 to pi by 2 the value will be positive, and at 0 there will be no value defined. So cosec minus pi by 3 will be minus 2 by root 3. So the value of y is minus pi by 3. Hence the principal value of y of cosec inverse minus 2 by root 3 is minus pi by 3. So we can see that we have discussed all inverse trigonometric functions, all 6 trigonometric functions. These are the basic ones. Now here sine, cos, tan, cosec, secant, cot. Every function's domain is given, and you can clearly see that the domain of the inverse function is exactly like the range of the trigonometric functions. The range of the sine function was minus 1 to 1 close interval, so this becomes the domain of sine inverse. The range of the tan inverse was R, so now here it becomes the domain of tan inverse function. The range of cosec function was R minus open interval minus 1 to 1. This becomes now the domain of cosec inverse function. Clearly for all the functions we can see that whatever was the range of the trigonometric functions now becomes the domain of the inverse trigonometric functions. Only change is there in the range to make it 1 1 and 1 2. So these all the values are very important for all of you to remember, that these are the value which are important when we are finding the values of the given inverse trigonometric function. Now, this is all for our inverse trigonometric functions. Now, from this chapter, what you can be asked is the graph of the inverse trigonometric functions, or the domain or range of the inverse trigonometric functions. And questions related to same concept are already uploaded in the SAS group. This is SAS app. So you all are supposed to do that worksheet and send me all those done worksheet on the mentioned mail ID, which I have already shared with you. And in the next session, we are going to discuss the properties of inverse trigonometric functions. And remember that this chapter is very important. Thank you.